Hello guys, and welcome to the second tutorial of the series of C++ programming. And in this tutorial we are going to see about a hello world program in the C++. In the last tutorial we have seen about how to install code blocks and how to download it. Okay, so in this tutorial we have opened the code blocks, and I'm going to show you that how you can start with code blocks. So first you have to open the code blocks, then you have to go on create a new project. And after that there is option of console application. Just go on it and click it and go and do the next and choose the C++ and again do the next. And here you have to give the project title, so we will give the project title like my project and do the next again. Here is a GNU GCC compiler. You don't have to do the changes in this, just click on the finish. And here is a tree. Okay, so it will create like tree. So here are sources and here is our main.cpp. so just double click this file and you will see the program which is by default in the code blocks. So this is the hello world program, which is the basic program in the C++. So that this is the beginning of the programming in the code blocks. So let me tell you about this a little bit. So this is the hash include iostream. So this is the preprocessor directive. Okay, so we will use it in our future programs because it's a necessary thing in the C++. The second line is a blank space. You can give as many blank spaces in the code blocks as you want. It just increase the readability. Okay, so third one is using namespace std. So std is a standard library. Okay, so these are the some standard libraries which are included in the C++. So the fourth one is again the blank space, and from here the main program starts. Okay, so this is the int main and these are the parentheses. In these two parentheses there is a code, cout, then hello world and endl. Okay, so cout, what cout is, it basically uses to print the stuff on the screen so that we can print the hello world on the screen. So that's why we use cout. And this is the stream insertion operator. So whatever you write in between these two stream insertion operators, that will be printed on the screen. Okay, so right now we have written hello world. Okay, and this is the endl, which means the end of the line. Okay, and after every instruction you have to give the semicolon so that the compiler will know that the line has ended. And the last one is return 0. Return 0 is used in this because it gives you that the program is executed successfully. That's why we use return 0. So let's run this program. There is a button like play and the setting. So build and run and click on it. And you can see the program has executed successfully. So this is our output, hello world. Like you can see in the program, hello world is our output which we have printed on the screen. So in this way you can print whatever you want to print on the screen. You just have to do the changes here. So I will put YouTube and again build and run. So again the program has executed successfully and you can see the output on the screen. So this is the basic things in the C++. In the next tutorial I will tell you more things in the C++. So until then, just practice these things, and thanks for watching and please subscribe to my channel.